the way I look, I know I look bad. It's like 9:38 p.m. on a Saturday night. Today's January 14th. That's the day I'm filming this. Wanted to film a video because one of my favorite YouTubers, they went live off of Twitch. They just got done being live. They were live for 2 hours and 12 minutes. That's a long fucking time to be live. But, when they were live, I went live today, the day I'm filming this, and I deleted the live because I'm like, it's not a live that's worth staying up, because I wanted to instead just film a video talking about it, so that's what I'm doing. I went live while they were live because I thought they were about to end the live. They end up not ending the live, but I'm thinking about making a Twitch account. I have one, obviously. How else would I be able to watch them be live? But I might make another one, separate one, for going live off. I will not be able to play games off of Twitch like most creators on that platform do. Because my laptop that I have right now, right here, can't even run Filmora, the editing software. Like, the only editing software app, whatever you want to call it, it can run is literally CapCut. I need to get a new laptop. I need to spend like $500 on one, but my mom will be the one buying one when I get one, hopefully in March of this year, and my budget is $300 and below. Like, not even $300, like $280 and below. So, like, I'm screwed on getting, like, a really, really great laptop. Unless y'all know of a laptop that's on Amazon. Because I'm only looking at Amazon. I'm not looking at Walmart. Because every time I've gotten a laptop of Walmart, this is probably, like, the third laptop I've gotten from Walmart. Walmart.com. Whether it be Walmart.com or the in-store Walmart. Whatever it be. From Walmart. They always end up not being good laptops. So, I'm only looking at Amazon. So, if you know of awesome, great quality laptops that are on Amazon and they're below, I want $285 below that price range, link the link to the laptop on Amazon in the comments down below this video. That would be much appreciated if you do. If you don't, that's fine. But it's been one hell. Like, I stopped searching around Christmas time because I thought I was gonna get a laptop at Christmas time. Ended up not, because every laptop that I found that was below 150, because that's all my mom could do for Christmas, was 150. I did more research into the laptop, every laptop that I found that I was gonna get, and they ended up not being good laptops. So I just said, suck it, I'm gonna wait till next year. So it's next year. Wait until March. I don't know, hang on, let me fix my lamp. I just not know this. My lamp thing is dented. Okay, there we go. As I was saying is, I'm struggling. I know that I stopped looking, I want to start looking again, but I know the second I'm going to start looking, my mood for the week is going to go down, because I know for a fact I'm not going to be able to find a laptop in the price range that I need it to be. It needs to be $200 and below, and it needs to be a great laptop. The price inflation lately is skyrocketing, which means laptops are going up in price as they should, but like, so it's becoming harder to find a cheap, amazing laptop that I can edit videos off of, because I'm sick of fucking editing videos off of my phone. I will continue to film videos off of my phone, that's something I can do. But I'm sick of having to edit videos on my phone. I'm sick of when I want to go live, not me having to go live off of my phone, or like, I can't it's become a harder direct to videos now because I'm using my TV direct to videos, and then I have to like edit it, the video way harder. And like, I should be able to do reaction videos like other YouTube other YouTubers do, where like they screen record the laptop and put their overlay their FaceTime on screen, and that's all done. You don't even have to edit it that much because of OBS software. My computer cannot run all OBS software at the rate it should. Like, I have a USB camera webcam for my laptop. I can connect to my laptop via USB. That is 1080p 60 frames per second. My laptop can run the 1080p, it just can't run the 60 frames per second. OBS like crashes every time I try to go live and do all that, or just film a regular ass video not being live. It like crashes. I'm sick of that. I'm sick of having a laptop that does that. Like, it's caused me to barely use my laptop anymore. And before I started this YouTube journey, I was using my laptop every single fucking day. I mean, the number one thing that's the second thing that my laptop does that bothers me. But the first thing is it makes this loud, annoying noise. I think it needs the fans replaced. I don't know how you do that. But I need a new one anyway, so I'm hoping the next one I do get does not make a noise. Because the noise it makes, no laptops should be making that noise. So it's not a noise that laptops make. It's a noise that I shouldn't be making. So I come to the conclusion why it makes that noise is it needs the fans replaced. I don't know how you fucking do that. Like, every time I try to watch, just like watch something off of it if I don't want to use my TV or something. Or just like, just for random ass shit, whenever I try to use it, it makes that noise. So I'm over the laptop I have now. I've had it since 2020. And when I first got it, it never made the noise. I want to say a year after having it, owning it, it started making the noise. I don't know. The laptop, I believe when I first got it, it was like 180. I don't remember, but I do remember going into my Walmart account and then looking to find the receipt or whatever you call it, looking to find the thing. It's now like worth like, I believe, $230. I'm like, bro, the laptop's not even that good. And you have it worth more than it should be worth. Because if I'm having trouble with it, with the laptop you have listed, I can't see why nobody else is not having trouble with it. It's making a noise. Like, other laptops that are the same exact laptop I have right now, people should be having problems with it too. It is and if you're wondering what kind of laptop it is an HP laptop model 14. And let me tell you, I don't like it at all. Like, earlier, yesterday, I had to send something to my laptop because it was something that had a lot of storage that I needed to store, but I didn't have enough storage to store on my phone, so I had to send it from my phone to my laptop. My laptop started making that noise, and it took like a good 2 hours for it. Yesterday was a nightmare having to deal with the noise while just doing the thing I know what to do. Watch YouTube, watch Netflix, whatever I do throughout the day. It was annoying having to listen to that noise for 2 hours. The noise did not go away until I turned off my laptop and I was done sharing the thing. Like, I don't know why I even went through buying this laptop in 2020. I should have just yelled at my mom and been like, I'll wait a whole nother fucking year to get a laptop. I don't even remember what laptop I had at that point. I don't even think I had a laptop at that point. I think I had a tablet. I didn't even have a phone back then. Because the first time I got a phone was... Wait, now? It was Christmas of 2019. That's when I got a phone. Okay. I'm getting Christmases mixed up. I had a phone for 3 years now. Like, I never had... I had, like, a phone where you had to, like, pay the minutes every month or something like that to text. Like, it's one of those cheap-ass phones. The data did not work at all. It wasn't even a working phone at that point to me because whenever I would go out to eat, I would have to use data, right? The data didn't work. Like, it kind of load shit. The data was slow. I just took it as I have no data. This one's shit. I stopped using it, so I think an actual phone with components that work, like working data and everything, for the first, I want to say, year and a half, I didn't have unlimited data like I have now. My mom had to get the unlimited data plan because she had to get an iPhone. So, you have to get the unlimited data. You have to get unlimited data to have an iPhone. So, I have unlimited data now. But for the first year and a half, I want to say, it was hell because my mom was getting on to me every time I would go over the data limit. And I would get mad at myself because I'm like, fuck. Now my mom's gonna yell at me. That I have to look forward to every day. And I was going to school in person at this point still. So I was using data throughout the day. There was nothing I could do to stop it. The school Wi-Fi sucked. And the school Wi-Fi blocked you off of shit. So, I was using my data because it blocked me off of shit. I could watch YouTube. I could listen to fucking music at lunch. Without the school Wi-Fi having it blocked off. So I got to a point where I could had to stop wanting to do things I want. And every time one of my friends wanted to use my phone for something, I had to start telling them, no, you can't, because my mom will kill me if I go over the data limit accidentally without knowing. So now having unlimited data, I'm talking, it rocks, having unlimited. No, it sounds like I'm bragging, but if y'all can afford unlimited data, get that motherfucking unlimited data plan. Because it's amazing. Because every time I go to my sister's now, I have to listen to my mom gripe at me, yell at me about going over the data limit. And every time, my sister lives 2 hours away. So every time I go to my sister's, which is few and far in between now, I don't have to worry about her yelling at me about going over the data limit. It's amazing. And I want to say I've had unlimited data for a year and a half, which is not that long at the same time. But when my mom got the unlimited data plan, my able to like have a data mobile hotspot, data hotspot, aka connect my tablet to my data if I needed Wi-Fi on my tablet. Like, I didn't have that option for, like, a good, I want to say, several months after she got it, because it kept on popping up. You're not eligible for this plan, or eligible to use this. And I'm like, bruh, I went to my mom uses ATT, so I went to the ATT website. I did all this Googling. I should have been able to use my mobile hotspot. So I don't know what was going on there. It could have been my phone just glitching out or just having some sort of problem. But now, I can connect to my data without no problem. It could have been just taking a few months for get used to the new plan or whatever. I don't know what I'm trying to say, but. And I noticed recently I started editing videos badly. I add music to the background of these videos and editing, so the video doesn't turn out to be that boring of a video. And I believe 2, 3, 4 videos I've added music to it, but the music's so quiet you can barely even fucking hear it. So when I go to edit this video and I add music, feature Kaylin here, feature me here, talking to you, add music loud enough, make sure, connect a fucking Bluetooth speaker at least so you know for a fact if the music's there or not. Because I swear, if I upload another video where y'all can barely even hear the music, I'm not even gonna post the video. Like, that video is just gonna go in the garbage, and that might be a day y'all not get a video. But, it's good to take breaks from YouTube, even if it be for a day. Or 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. So, I don't plan on taking another break from YouTube for a good while, once say for a couple months, 2, 3 months. Maybe after like 4, 5, I'll take a break. Because once I've been consistent for months, that's when I get proud of myself and I can pat my back and I can be like, you did it. You've been consistent for a while. You can now tell your followers, tell these people, hey, I'm taking a break. I'll be back soon. I can't wait for that day I do take a break though. Like, I'm gonna cry to think about it. Because I'm gonna be proud of myself at that stage. I've been consistent for, at that point, I want to say 5, 6 months. Maybe even 7. It takes a lot out of me to film YouTube videos, and it probably does for every creator. It takes a lot. And for you to keep doing it every single goddamn day. Every single goddamn day. It takes a lot out of you. Even editing takes a lot out of me. And I think what I'm trying to say is thank you for going on this journey with me. It's been a crazy journey. Crazy journey. Like, I made this account. Let me use my tablet to figure out what day I made it. But I know I made it 2018, maybe 2019. Let's say when the anniversary for this channel is, the birthday for this channel, this is what we can call it. Let's go here, let's not click that. Your channel, boom, go to about. Here we go. Joined, aka made a YouTube account, March 16th of 2018. At 2 months until the anniversary, birthday, whatever you call it, of the show. 2 months. When y'all are seeing this video, like a month and a half at that point, I believe. March 16th, 2019. And this, I'm not trying to sound cocky, I swear. The amount of total views I have on every single video posted on this channel is 59,557 views. Let's try to reach, this might be a stretch, let's try to reach 61,000 views on this channel. Let's try. I believe we can do it. Let's try to reach 61,000 views. Now I'm gonna have to film a lot of videos, but, and hopefully a lot of my videos, promise you I'm not trying to sound cocky and do blow up a little. Y'all wondering what the most popular video I posted on the channel was is my shower routine video, that's what it's titled, that one has 23,000 views. That one, when it blew up, I was shocked. That was 11 months ago. I'm like, how the fuck does this random... I clicked on it. On accident. But, I'm like, how does this random ass shower routine video just get 23,000 views? And I think it's because shower routines were popping off at on YouTube at that time. I don't know. I think the title is what really got it to pop up. The thumbnail is trash, so I don't even know where to begin with the it popping off. Like, y'all let me know in the comments of this video, how do y'all think that video popped off? It's literally titled My Shower Routine. Like, My Shower Routine. Like, I'll...
First thing I do...
Listen to it.
Before I get in the shower is I go grab clothes. So usually in the laundry room, in the dryer. So I go get clothes. Go get my
clothes. Let's see here.
Bathroom. But I put them in the bathroom just in case.
I'm gonna scroll through the video. Why is the video just not playing? Okay, will the video play?
So get hairbrush, and I'm gonna pull it right. And I'll be grabbing it, so. Y'all can have to deal with the crappy lighting for this video. I hope you guys all like this nighttime routine slash daytime routine. Video.
I do need to film like a new kind of video because my shower routine has kind of changed a little bit. I use different products than I put in that video now, so I think it's kind of long overdue for a new shower routine video. But I tried to put that video off because I don't want people thinking, oh, that's the most popular video on my channel. I want to remake it because I want to profit off that video again, aka more views, subscribers, likes. No, if I recreate that video, I'm not even recreating that video. It's an update, like I want to update y'all on what crap I use that's good. So if y'all need, like, if y'all want to what good shower stuff to use, like, if you have dandruff, I have dandruff. I have to use dandruff shampoo and conditioner. Like, I could give y'all some good dandruff shampoos because I've been through the mud with that. And I need to find a good dandruff shampoo. Conditioner, for me, it's been a little easier to find a dandruff conditioner. I use a different brand of conditioner than I use for shampoo. So I've been through the mud with dandruff shampoo. And with like good scented body washes. Like I'm still going through hell with that. And body washes that last me over a month. Because I go through body wash more faster than I should. I go through a lot of shit faster than I should. Which I am working on that, working on it. And one thing I want to do this year that I know for a fact I'm not going to do is try to lose the weight. Because I went to the doctor, I weighed 224 fucking pounds. My doctor doesn't care because they diagnosed me wrong. I know that for a fact now. They said I have a UTI, I don't. But, I have to get my weight checked. I weigh 224 pounds. My mom has given me hell about my weight, and it's kind of starting to make me insecure at this point. I'm out. Every time she says that, I'm like in my head, fuck you. Like, who are you to give somebody shit about their fucking weight? You're like a trig. Like, you need to start eating more. And I say this in my head. Because I'm like, well, if you're going to give me hell about my weight, I'm going to treat you how you're going to treat me, and I'm just going to give you hell about your weight. So. I mean, my dad, I know my dad's weight is a lot too, so I think it's like, my grandpa weighed a lot, my grandma weighs a lot, so I think it's like a gene thing where I'm gonna be heavy whether I like it or not. But then again, I was on a lot of medication for my behavior a few years back. I want to say 8, 9, 10, 11. I was going through a lot, and every medication I was on, it was making me eat more, aka making me gain lots and lots of weight to the point where I'm at the way I am now. Like, I used to be a fucking trig. Like, I used to be the weight that my mom is. I used to look the way my mom did. Or does. Now I'm 17 and I don't. Like, I want to be... The goal weight I want to be is 100 and at least 120. Yes, I do want to be skinny. That ain't me being insecure about it. I'm not insecure about my weight. I am insecure about my, I will say this, the only thing I'm insecure about is the stretch marks that's on my belly because of my weight. That's the only thing that bothers me. Because I look at my stretch marks and I'm like, it bothers me. And as the months grow, I start thinking more about my weight. I think I'm slowly becoming insecure about my weight. Slowly. I hate to say it because I've never been insecure. Never. I want to be... Okay, fuck it. I'm insecure. Like, I want to be the weight I was. When I was 8, 9, 10. I want to be the weight I was. I want to look the way I did. Not with the same haircut. My hair back then was god-awful. But I want to look the way I did back then. Like, I would be the hottest bitch alive if I weighed the weight I want to be. I know that to be a goddamn fact. And I'm not. I want to be skinny. I don't want my mom griping at me, like, every other month about how I should lose the weight. Like, I know I should. It's hard. When all I drink is pop, eat candy, or not candy, eat sugar. Like, very unhealthy foods is hard. And when you become addicted to that, it's like cigarettes. When you become addicted to that, it's very, very hard to, like, break it. And with you drinking pop every day, with poppy in my house, I'm gonna break... If I was to go on like a diet or something, I would break that diet within like 2 days. Because this pop always in the fridge because you drink pop. So it would be very hard for me to like lose the weight. I want to. You have no idea how bad I want to. I weigh 224 pounds. So I would have to quite literally lose 100 pounds. And how do I do that all in the span of a year? I just want to look the way I did. I want to take you on a lose the weight journey. Trust me. A YouTuber I'm subscribed to, Corey Shear, he's trying to lose 45 pounds in 45 days. Posting a video every single day. I want to do that kind of thing. Like he's doing. Go on like. Loosely. The weight journey with me. But I'm not at the point where I can start filming videos like that. Because I'm not at the point where I can. Quite so easily lose the weight. It sounds easy. It's better said than done. Let's put it that way. and the weather around here for me to start going to like runs, jogs, walks, I would have to wait till the summer because it's too fucking cold, or the springtime. Now Monday, this coming Monday when I'm filming this, it's supposed to be 70. So I might go on a run then, I might film a video then. I am scared to leave my house though because there have been reported break-ins. So I lost my house key. Second house key I've lost. So I wouldn't be able to lock the door unless I'm gonna be locked out of my own goddamn house while my mom's at work. So it would be a quick fast run, less than 10 minutes. I'm trying to figure out if I was to go on like a walk Monday, where I would walk to. I think the farthest I would walk is to like the high school that I kinda live by. There's a couple of different ways I could walk to it though. But I think I'm gonna go like the way that my park is by my house. Because less car traffic. Now like an actual street. I think that's the farthest I'd walk. But like I get embarrassed when I go on walks because what if somebody looks at me and then talks to me and is like, hey, why are you walking? I am insecure about my height too because I'm like 5'3", 5'4". And I'm short, so I think that causes me to look younger than I am. I'm 17. I want to be at least like 5'8". Like, that's the maximum height I would want to be, is 5'8". Or like, the maximum. I would love to be like 5'11". That would be amazing too. I would love to be as tall as Chad Michael Murray, and he's like 6'1". So, don't ask me how I know what Chad Michael Murray's height is. Okay, I'll tell y'all. Listening to a podcast that he was on, I want to say like a year ago. It was the guy who plays Luke on Gilmore Girls, the actor of him. He has a podcast, and Chad Michael Murray was on that podcast, and he said his height in that podcast. But I am getting this video here. It's a 33-minute long video. It's gonna be probably longer because I have to add my intro and everything to it, but get in this video here. If you liked it, don't forget to, I don't know why I just did the peace sign, but don't forget to like it. Please do like it. It helps the algorithm. All that BS. No, I'm kidding. You don't have to like it. If you're not already subscribed, what are you doing? You just watched a 33-minute long video, probably longer than that when I get done editing it and everything. You just watched like a 35-34-minute long video of me. What are you fucking doing? Hit that damn subscribe button. You obviously like me if you stayed here throughout the whole goddamn entire video, so hit that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell to get notified every time I post a new video. I post a new video every other day at 12:50 p.m. CST, Central Standard Time. But I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace, guys. Bye.